Welcome back to STL TV Live. I'm Sarah Thompson, and joining me to talk about the popular tradition known as the Taste of St. Louis are Vito Racanelli, executive chef of Taste of St. Louis and owner of Mad Tomato in Clayton, and Kay Sonderaker. I knew I was going to get it. Sonderaker, who is the co-director of Budweiser's Taste of St. Louis and has actually been a part of St. Louis. This is her baby since the very beginning. So it's so great to have you both here. This is like a huge tradition in St. Louis. This has become like the big fall event that everyone goes to. But something's new this year. It's not downtown, it's in Chesterfield.
Yes.
You want to talk about that, Kay?
Sure. We had a great opportunity to showcase. We've got some really great culinary chefs coming this year, which we can talk about in a little bit. But we had a great opportunity to showcase them on an amphitheater stage type setting. So Chesterfield Amphitheater lent itself to that, and we thought, why not? We've had 9 fantastic years in the city. Let's try something new. Let's bring the city and the county together and really kind of get things mixed up and going. And it's our 10th year anniversary. So what a better way to celebrate than trying something a little different and really getting a great bang for everybody.
Yeah. No, a lot of people who, if they haven't been, Taste of St. Louis, I mean, it's everything. There's the big, we can talk about the food, of course, but there's the big food component and the restaurants, but there's live music and everything. So I want to kind of cover that in our interviews today. Why don't we start off, though, of course, because we have food on set. So, Chef, start off with the food and tell us about everything Restaurant Row, about the competitions, everything that we can expect on the culinary side.
Well, what I could say about Taste of St. Louis is that it's a foodie's paradise. I mean, we have some of the region's best restaurants. We have Annie Gunn's, and we have Balaban's and Edgewild, and mm-hmm. some of the cities, you know, city and county, some of their best restaurants. So I mean, if you're really wanting to sample what St. Louis has to offer, that's the place to go, mm-hmm. because they'll all be together in one area, and you can really kind of peruse through just all different types of cuisine.
We actually have 40 restaurants this year.
40 restaurants.
40 restaurants.
Yeah, no, yeah. I know normally you guys have around 30, but you've got 40 restaurants here. That's great. So there's Restaurant Row where people can go and sample the different foods that each restaurant has provided. But a lot of people love that you bring in the Food Network chefs and you have the culinary competitions. So talk a bit about that.
Well, this year's culinary competitions, I would say, are going to probably be some of the best.
Okay.
I mean, it just spreads across the region. When we were in the city, we had a lot of city staff chefs and some chefs in St. Louis County. But this year, it's a good mix of both. And this year, we have ACF involvement, the American Culinary Federation, which are going to be assisting in all the judging. And that's just, you know, that really makes this the best culinary competition in the region.
It's a tough competition.
I mean, don't the competitions have, like, you have to use a certain ingredient?
Yes, we have 7 battles. Yeah, and each battle has a different ingredient and is timed, so there's some pressure there.
Yeah.
And they don't find out what the ingredient is until close to before the event, so they're scrambling to practice, and yeah, it's really cool.
Yeah, we meet with the chefs and we go over all the rules, and then we let them know what they're where they're competing and who they're competing against. But the camaraderie amongst the chefs is just amazing. Mm-hmm. They get together, they all get to know each other, and everybody becomes a friend at the end of this. Mm-hmm. And it's really, really great, and we use local ingredients. We partner with local farmers and a local grocery store to do so, and that's what really makes it exciting. So
I do want to mention there, because we had one of the photos of it, is there's the beer garden too, and that's pretty big because you have different beers that people can sample. Is that correct, Kay?
Actually, we have a Beers of the World feature.
Beers of the World.
And that's going to be inside the amphitheater, which is the new thing we're doing this year. So when you purchase a ticket to the amphitheater, so the entire event is free. Mm-hmm. But this year, we're bringing in some Food Network chefs, which is actually the first time we've ever really done it at this level. We've had some people that have been in from Chopped and some other shows, but this is kind of the ultimate food experience year for us. So we're bringing in some big heavy hitters from the Food Network, and they're going to be inside the amphitheater, which that part is going to be ticketed. So when you get a ticket to the amphitheater, you also get the Beers of the World experience. So there's 16 different beers you can try from all over, and you get, 10 samples, 10 3-ounce samples with your ticket. So that's kind of a cool addition that we haven't done before.
What do you think from 10 years of doing this? And I know, Chef, you've been involved as the executive chef for 5 years, you're saying. So, I mean, what do you think is the one consistent thing that people come to love and expect, and then the one sort of variable that you feel you always change up?
I think people come for the variety of stuff mm-hmm. we have. We have a kids city area. We have a showcase stage where there's demos going on all weekend long. We have the ever popular Chef Battle Royale culinary battles, the Stella Artois Chef Battle Royale. We've got music that we always bring in, and this year we've got the Food Network talent, and then of course Restaurant Row. I think people love to come and just try stuff from all different places and, and get some new favorites.
And do you like, I think probably the changing it up is adding more restaurants each year, is that kind of the versatility that you come to enjoy?
Oh yeah, we want everyone that, to, I mean the purpose of going to something like this is to try different things,
yes.
to really get exposure to different types of foods, cuisines, different restaurants, meet new chefs. I mean, it's great to really see what's going on in the St. Louis culinary scene because it's really vibrant.
Yeah.
And we're very fortunate to say that we do have some of the best restaurants and chefs in the region.
Oh, absolutely.
And then bringing in the Food Network chefs, you know, and I got to peek at their demos.
You
know, I'm not saying, but all I'm saying is they are going to be really, really cool. And, you know, I mean, that, there's a reason why they're Food Network chefs. They are, because they know what they're doing. And I've seen what they're doing. So I think it's well worth it to go and
check them out. Yeah,
sure.
Well, we're going to take a quick break because when we come back, I do want to hear more about the music and Kid City. So please stay with us. We're going to have more about Taste of St. Louis when we return.